Happy Friday. Welcome to my channel. This is Full Throttle Kind of Guy, coming at you the end of the month, March. Going to be talking about a subject that you may find shocking. There's a pun intended on that one. It's going to be talking about batteries, and particularly car batteries. And there's a phenomenon that a lot of people haven't noticed yet. But when you go to buy a brand new car battery, you're going to be seeing some interesting things. Plus, I've also got an update in regards to decals and a new shirt. Stick around, I've got more coming up. Hey, never been to the channel before? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. So, stick around. Again, happy Friday, and thank you for spending some time with me. If you're new to the channel, please give a like, give a subscribe, ring the bell thingy too, that kind of helps. Anyways, in regards to the fun part first, decals. I'm always dabbling and stuff. I've got a new decal that I made. So if you're still interested in doing a decal swap, hit me up and we'll make some magic happen. I've also got a brand new shirt, and I'll be getting a link up to that as well. It's available on Sticker Mule. So, built, not bought. And again, made by me. I'm not making a dime or anything off of this, but I'm making the print available. So if you're interested, hey, support me, support the channel, and keep me motivated. Let's keep things going. We always talk about quality this, quality that. The one thing I've seen a really reduction in quality in is car batteries. I believe this all started thanks to a lawsuit some consumers filed against Interstate Batteries. Batteries used to like to play this one game where you'd have a six-year battery. Yes, six-year battery. Five-year batteries, too. And there are different terms in that. Well, the battery companies would play the game of they'd give you the first 3 years free replacement. Then afterwards, they would prorate your batteries. So, having said that, there was this big enigma of, was it really a six-year warranty or five-year warranty? Why didn't I just get a new battery? So on and so forth. The people won against Interstate Batteries. And that information is out there on the internet. I'm not really going to go too deep about it. But since then, there's been some big changes. The one thing I did notice is the quality of car batteries has gone down substantially. I don't know if it's because, you know, they're outsourcing parts, they're using heavily recycled parts. There could be anything that's going on. One theory I have, it has something to do with EVs, and that they're gearing themselves to put the best parts forward so when they do an EV battery, you know, in other words, through a company to sell you a secondary EV battery on the market, they're going to try to make it more affordable, but they would rather sell one EV battery to them and get, you know, $4,000 or $5,000 for it, as opposed to us, you know, only giving them a measly $150 for battery. I think the battery quality issue is also extending across towards the high-end AGM, the glass mat batteries like Optima. The typical glass mat battery, I think, is lasting anywhere from 2 to 5 years, which is ridiculous. The regular batteries now, you're lucky if you can get 3 years out of a car battery. I went to Wally World and bought a battery. They sell them now in 1, 2, or 3 year warranties on the batteries. Yeah, you heard that right. 1, 2, or 3 years. So gone is your 5 year warranty on batteries. That doesn't exist anymore. They're not really prorating anything. So you have to pay more money in order to get more cold cranking amps and a better warranty. There's gonna be a lot of theories on, well, I'd rather pay, you know, $55 and get a battery that only puts out, you know, 650 cold cranking amps, as opposed to you want a car battery that puts out 850 cold cranking amps and you're paying like $140, which I just recently did. So you'll have to do your research as far as to what batteries you want to stick with and whatnot. Gone are the days when you could run down to Sears, God rest her soul, and you could buy a diehard battery. Diehard batteries, in my mind, were some of the best batteries made in the U.S. by the U.S. You could buy a diehard. And granted, you might pay a little bit extra for it because you got it from Sears and they installed it for you. But this battery, you can get almost 10 years out of a good diehard, an OG diehard battery. You would get rid of the car before you got rid of the diehard battery. You could move that battery from car to car. You know, that's how long these batteries used to last back in the day. So, I digress. My focus is not so much, we know batteries and the quality of batteries suck, but what do you do to try to save money and cut corners when you can? Well, there's a lot of temptation to go to Craigslist or Facebook Marketplace, and you'll see guys selling batteries in the whole nine yards. Well, they can show you that the battery puts out 12 volts, but really, is it 12 volts? You know, and what I mean by that is there's a difference between having a 12 volt battery and a 12 volt battery that can crank a car. There's a tool that we used to use years ago. Granted, it used to be gigantic and you can do a lot of different tests. You can check your charging system, your cranking system, the whole nine yards, and then it will let you know if your battery had enough to crank a car. So let me show you what I got recently off of Amazon. This is the I'll be cutting that one out. So this is what I got off of Amazon. It's a Con Y, and I'll have a link on it in the description as well. I'm trying to do the whole Amazon thing. It was only $29, had it delivered to my door. Couldn't ask for anything better. You know, I didn't want to go out to, you know, the stores and whatnot, and you end up spending more money than you want to. At the time I purchased it, it was only $29. I think there's a special on it right now. They're like $23 and change. Your mileage may vary depending upon where you are in the U.S., so on and so forth. But with this, you can do the same thing that big monstrous box could do, but with more power in your hands. So you can do in-car tests, out-of-car tests, check your charging system. You can check your cranking system and see if there's an issue with the starter. So going back to some of the basics as far as diagnostics and that. So this is going to be an excellent tool for you. But if you do decide to buy a battery, you could say, okay, well, I've got a high-speed test light, and it'll tell me, you know, what the voltage is on the battery, and you're going to presume, again, it's putting out 12 volts. It's putting out 12 volts, sure, but what's the cold cranking amps? I'll show you this a little bit closer, and you can see what I'm talking about. So hang on just a second. I'll get everything resituated for us here, and we'll make the magic happen. Okay, so here's the old 5-year warranty, which is gone with the dodo birds. And we see it was a 800 cold cranking amp battery. So here we'll just push this against it. Sorry, I got my hands all shaky all over the place, like the shakiest gun in the West. You see it's 12.4. So you're thinking, okay, that's enough to light up an engine. Is it really? I don't think so. But let's use the meter to tell us more. So, again, this verifies, I don't know how well you can see it, against the light. Here, let me peel off this, which I hate to do, but yeah, it's like a solar system in here. Hang on a second, let me kill one of the lights. I'm doing this just because I really care about you guys. All right, here we go. God dang, it's like washed out on the screen. You can't even see anything. All right, so 12.65 volts. So what we're going to do is this. We'll go ahead and do a checkerini. and let's see what it is we got. All right, let's check. Out of vehicle, regular flooded. We're looking for cold cranking amps. Look at that, cold cranking amps, just 400. That is it. So this is good to keep around the shop because one, the core deposits on your battery. You know, sometimes you can also take it by some parts stores and they'll give you a gift card for turning it in for a core charge. I use it to help air up my tires in my car. It'll help run my compressor. So, but even on the bottom, see the recommendation when it says to replace. So yeah, this will not pass any tests. So 5-year battery up in smoke. So again, this really is worth its money. You know, like I said, if you're going to buy a battery secondarily off of, you know, Marketplace or whomever, or go to a boneyard and try to get a battery, you know, potentially you're going to get burned, which that's the last thing we want to see happen, especially when you're working on a budget. Let me go ahead and reorganize everything. I'll be right back. There you have it. Comes back to the basics, you know, as far as being able to diagnose something, to check it out, to make sure, you know, what am I looking at? Going back to the rudimentary tests that we have before you go plunking money down on a battery, whether you're paying some guy $25 who does the magical repurposing of batteries, or you're over there trying to use an arc welder to recharge the battery, whatever voodoo's going on. At the end of the day, batteries and battery life, it's terrible. It really is. You're going to get burned. So, you know, even if you have a trickle charger, you try to store the battery indoors, whatever. Life of batteries, it ain't what it used to be. So, caveat emptor, at least, like I said, consider some of the basics, and this is a really good tool to own in your toolbox. So, that's all I have for now. I've got some different car parts in that's come in. I'm getting everything organized for next phases. I'll have some more footage out on that. I'll get some more content. So, again, thank you for spending today, you know, watch my little short video on it. I appreciate it. Again, give me a like, give me a subscribe. Check out the link in Amazon and see what you think about that, or at least some other tools you can choose to help you with you know, working on your projects. So this is a nice little tool so you can be built, you know, built it yourself, not bought it. So anyways, have a great day. Enjoy the weekend. Enjoy your time with your family. Make some memories. I appreciate you spending some time with me tonight. Take care.